It's an embalmer's job to ensure that a deceased loved one is given the same respect in death that they deserved in life, and facial feature setting is a huge part of that. But what practical purpose does this procedure serve? Funerals can be heartbreaking experiences, and wakes can be eerie and surreal if the deceased is on display inside an open casket. Even though death is a natural part of life, the vast majority of us don't exactly look forward to it.
Amen.
The human body decays after death, rapidly. The most dramatic decay happens within the first month after death. Cells throughout the body die, rigor mortis sets in, then the body bloats from gases, changes colors, and foam and other fluids ooze from orifices. It's not a pretty sight. After that, the body begins its slow disintegration towards skeletonization over the course of years, or even decades. Morticians and funeral directors help plan funerals and wakes, but it's embalmers who have the grisly responsibility of physically handling and preparing a body for viewing and burial. Embalming isn't exactly a new practice. The ancient Egyptians were so good at it that the mummies of their dead exist all the way to the present. Smithsonian says that they took 70 days to remove a body's organs, keep the corpse dry, wrap the body in linen, and so forth. In the modern day, embalming follows a different but equally strict procedure. As Everplans explains, bodies are washed, their fluids drained, and jaws sewn or wired shut. Embalmers do this to prevent the mouth from opening, as mouths naturally open when muscles are relaxed. Jaws are sewn or wired shut as part of an entire facial setting process. As Funeral Guide explains, the goal is to manipulate facial features to resemble as natural of an expression as possible. To that end, the eyes are closed, and the embalmer uses glue or oval-shaped eye caps to keep the eyes shut, according to Everplans. Hair is combed and set, and faces are shaved, unless a person wore a beard while alive. Jaws require a complicated procedure to keep them closed and to keep the deceased's features intact. If a jaw is sewn shut, embalmers pass thread through the lower gums in the front of the mouth below the bottom front teeth and up to the upper gums above the top front teeth. They then pass the thread from the upper gums into one nostril, then through the septum, the cartilage separating the nostrils, into the other nostril and back down into the mouth. From there, an embalmer can tighten the thread and tie it off. An experienced embalmer explained to The Guardian that to close a mouth by wire, an embalmer uses a device called a needle injector that drives a tack into the upper and lower jaws. The tacks connect to wires that the embalmer ties together, and then the embalmer rotates the tacks to close the jaw. Those who visited loved ones at wakes can attest to the hard work that embalmers go through in order to make the deceased appear as natural as possible. This includes the setting of the features, hair, makeup, and clothing. Many people are disturbed at the viewing of a corpse, especially a loved one, but Funeral Guide explains that with the right attention to care, attendees often express surprise at how well a loved one looks. Nonetheless, it's important to remember that it's impossible for the deceased to look exactly like they did when alive. On that note, if someone has an accident before death that has damaged their face, that individual can undergo post-mortem surgery to reconstruct it. As Funeral Guide explains, this isn't surgery in the usual sense, and it's much less straightforward and standard of a procedure than the by-the-numbers embalming or jaw setting. Master embalmers Martin Jeffrey and Ross Corney in Edinburgh, Scotland, head up courses aimed at teaching embalmers the skill of post-mortem surgery. They work for William Purvis Funeral Directors, whose chairman Tim Purvis said of post-mortem surgery, "We don't go by photos of the person. They won't look exactly as they did in life. It's effectively like a jigsaw." The comfort, he said, comes from the loved ones knowing that the deceased received as much attention and care as possible, elaborating, "Wouldn't you want to know that a loved one had had that time spent on them rather than the coffin lid closed because they are in a bad way?" For those who want an open casket viewing, this is doubtlessly foremost on the mind.